This is creating Tappamole using code.org, and in particular the AppLab part of code.org. This is part two, which suggests that you probably should have watched part one, otherwise this is going to be very confusing, so make sure you watch part one first. So let's get coding. So let's click on code, and then I'm going to use the block editor for this game. So to start off with, I'm going to create a variable. There's lots of ways of doing this. This is just how I've done it. Okay, so I'm going to create a variable called score, and I'm going to initialize its value to 0. That just tells the computer I want to use something called score, and we're going to set its starting value to 0. Now, under UI controls, there's one called onEvent, and when we click this button, we want to start the game. So when we click on BTN start game, there's a few actions that need to take place. What needs to happen? Well, first off, I want to set my score to 0. And you might be thinking, well, you've already done that. But if you think about it, if we previously played the game, we probably want to reset score to 0 at some point, and this would be a sensible place to do it. So I'm going to set that score to 0. We are also going to want to change the screen. So there's one in here called set screen. Set screen. They're not in alphabetical order, so you have to hunt for them sometimes. And I want to set the screen to SCR game, which is the actual game. So I'll do that manually for a moment. So this will help us to think about what needs to happen. So we set score to 0, set the screen to SCR game, and we're going to want this puppy to disappear as well. So there's one here called, where is it? It's called hide element. Hide element. Oh, there it is at the bottom. Hide element and IMG puppy, right? So this disappears. And then we want to set a random position and size for our mole, right? And later on, we're going to want to do that for the puppy as well. So it would make sense to create what we call a function to do that, because functions are reusable. So under functions, I'm going to create a function. The second one down, define a function with parameters. So I'm going to drag that in at the bottom, and I'm going to call this update position. I'll leave that the set as I'm going to change that from N to IMG, right? So I'm going to update the position of an image that we're going to send to this function, right? This will make sense. If it doesn't make sense yet, it will do. So when we update the position, I want to generate a random X and Y position where it's going to be on the screen, and generate a random size as well. So under variables, I'm going to create one called size, and I'm going to create one called X, and I'm going to create one called Y. And these are all going to be set to a random number. So I'm going to track these in. Right, so the size, I think a good size will be between about 30 and 90 pixels. And the X position, I don't want it to appear right off the end of the screen, so I'm going to set the X to somewhere between 40 and 290. Okay, when you move the mouse, you can see the X and Y coordinates on the screen. And then the same for Y, which is how far. So X is how far across, Y is how far down, between, say, 40 and 410. So now all that's left to do is set the actual position. So under UI controls, there is one in here called set position. Set position. Can you see it? They're not in alphabetical order. There it is, set position. So ID, get rid of these quotation marks and type in IMG, right? Because that's the image that gets sent to this function. So in this case, it will be IMG mole. This next parameter is the X position. So I'm going to change that 0 to, guess what? X, this one, guess what? Y. And then this is the width and the heights, which I'm going to set to size, so that the actual shape of this will be a square, right? If you did want to change the height and width at random, then you could do if you wanted to. Right, that's update position. We created the function. So now after we've hidden the puppy, we want to call this function to actually move the mole. So in the functions, this one here, it says call a function with parameters, drag and drop that underneath hide elements. Where it says my function, type in update position. And then where it says n, use a quotation mark, symbol shift the number 2 on the keyboard and change this to img mole and then another quotation mark. Alright, so we call this function and we send to it the mole and then it will update the position of the mole. Pretty clever, huh? Okay, next job. Let's think about what happens when we click onto the mole itself. So under UI controls on event, so change this to IMG mole. When we click on the mole, what do we want to happen? We want the score to increase by 1. We want to update its position. And then we want there to be a random chance that the puppy appears. And if so, set its position and then make that disappear after a second. Right. Let's do all of that then. So under variables, I want to change my score. So I type in score. If you press the tab key, that goes to the next blank box. The tab key is the key above caps lock. Score plus 1. So that will increase the score. Score equals whatever it previously was plus 1. Then I can't remember what order I said we'll do things in, but never mind. Functions. Call the function with a parameter. Update position. So we update the position of the mole. Quotation mark, img mole. Quotation mark. So we send that to a function. Updates the position of the mole again to another new position on the screen, and then we want there to be a random chance that the puppy appears. So this is going to be a bit like rolling a dice, right? And if when we roll the dice, if say the number is number 1, then we want the puppy to appear. So under control there's one called if, so I drag that in. If, then under math there's one called equals, i.e. if our random number equals 1, then the puppy's going to appear. So random number, let's make a random number. So this is like the shaking the dice bits. Let's say between 1 and 5, so there's a 1 in 5 chance that the puppy appears. You can change the probability if you want to. So if this equals 1, then what do we want to happen? We want the puppy to appear. So where is it? We want to, can you remember what it's called to get the puppy to appear? Show element, there it is. Show element img puppy. We could select that from the list, and we also want to set its position. So we probably want to do that before it displays it on the screen. So update position, change that n to img puppy with the quotation marks. Okay, don't forget. So we send img puppy to our update function and then it updates its position on the screen. There we go, we are almost there. Right, what happens when we click on the puppy? UI control, so on event img puppy, when we click on the puppy we want the score decrease by 1 because we're not supposed to click on the puppies. So score equals score minus 1. And then we probably want the puppy to disappear. So hide element and then from the drop down img puppy. Right. And that's it. So after 5 seconds our game will end. It's not going to end yet because I haven't created the timer. When the game ends. So going back to the first page, when we think about it, right, when we click on the start game button we want to start a timer. So under control there's one called set timeout, right? So set timeout, which we want something to happen after 5 seconds. So I'm going to change this to 5,000. It's not 5,000 seconds, it's 5,000 milliseconds, which is 5 seconds. Right? So after 5 seconds, we want to change the screen game over. So in here, I'm going to want the one that says set screen to SCR game over, or I could just select that from the list. And then we want this number to update with whatever our score is. So there is a block in here that says set text. There it is, set text. And we want to set the text of the score label, label score, to the value of our score variable. Now, do not put quotation marks around this. If you put quotation marks around this, this would literally say score, S-C-O-R-E. We don't want that to happen. We want it to be the value of score. Hence why we write in score without the quotation marks. Right, so after 5 seconds, this screen will appear, and then this label will update with our score. Right, but what is going to happen when we click on this start over button? Right, we literally wanted to start again. Now, for some reason, oh yeah, I can just about drag this in. I was thinking that it wouldn't let me drag it in at the bottom, but it does. So on event, when we click the start over button, IMG start over, no, BTN start over, there it is. When we click on the start over button, we want to set the screen to our starting screen. Then with any luck, that should be it. Let's see if it works. Oh, it's not loading my model for some reason. Okay, images appear, but the images have not loaded. I've never seen this happen before. Oh, they appear now. Must have been a glitch on the interweb. Let's try it again. Start. Oh no, run. There we go. Click on the mole. 6. Not bad. Start over. Yeah, that all seems to be working absolutely fine. There looks to be a little internet error at the moment. Not sure why that's happened, but there we go. Anyway, I will leave some instructions for this on my website, so that will hopefully help you to create this game. Yeah, see if you can code this game and work out how the code works. And then if you've done that, maybe create a game of your own using what you have learned. And then I look forward to seeing what you come up with.